Today we're going to look at some updates from the Fortress dual RCD consumer unit from BG.
We'll find out.
Yeah, well, we've looked at this product, probably a year ago.
It was.
Actually on the channel. And we like it when brands we work with come back with improvements based on the feedback they've had from comments from viewers and installers out there who fit the product.
Yeah, because we went through the journey of looking at this consumer unit as well as installing it on site. And we're going to see if they've implemented some of those improvements, and we're going to recap some of the great features that this consumer unit has. And the first one being, it no longer goes to 10.
No, it goes to 11, Gary.
So why is that better?
Well, it's one more than 10.
It's one more than 10. So yeah. When we say 11, it's now an 11 way for the breakers.
Yes, but yeah. It's fitted, pre-fitted with 10.
It is?
Yes.
But it's actually pre-fitted with 11 because there's one in there for the surge, yes. Which has also been added. But already sneaking in there.
But there is a spare way. So let's dive in. Obviously, the first thing we like about this range is it is a single screwdriver for all screws.
It is. And we're using our slotted posi there because that's the one we're going to use for the breakers.
And the screws themselves.
Okay, let's have a quick look on the back.
Or captive. Ah, held with those washers, so they're not going to come out. You won't need to replace them with the wood screw.
Okay.
And the first thing is this unit, you know, combined with the lid and itself, is a substantial unit. Solid welded corners. It's not going anywhere. And I guess that first improvement they've made, Gary, that a lot of people said, was that when it's fully loaded up, the din rail tends to be a little bit springy.
Right, okay.
But behind here.
Okay, do you want to lift it up? Let's have a look. So lean in there. Let's just have a little look.
Yeah, behind there is the reinforced the din rail behind it. So that's not going anywhere when you tighten those wires.
So as I look at it here, we're obviously fixed here, we're fixed there, and we've also got a center fix in there that means that if we press against the center of that, we're not going to get any flexing
so
in there.
Two additional fixings in there.
Right, okay. So one wasn't enough, we went for two.
No, more metal. So we like that.
Yeah, we do. And we like the fact that it's that one screwdriver. Okay, so we've used a slotted posi to get the lid off, but all the screws within here also use the same screwdriver, and we'd expect them to be torqued up at the end.
Yeah.
The RCDs, shall we start with the RCDs by having a look at those? Because we've got to confirm they are what type?
The type A.
So let's see if we've got some type A RCDs in here.
Always good. But then the other major improvement, so on the last version of this consumer unit, this would have been 63.
Right.
And that's now 100. And this one would have been 63, and it's now 80.
Okay, that's so considering more than the 100 amps offered by the incoming fuse in a domestic dwelling.
Yeah, so that makes life a lot easier for those split load installations and obviously that division of circuits between those RCDs. So that's a big step forward.
And we've got a 40 amp breaker there. We've got 432s,
yes,
216s, and 36s. And then you said there's also a spare way.
Yeah, spare way at the end. And then obviously we've now got the standard surge kit fitted in there as well. With the breaker for that.
Okay, and that's a type 2 SPD as well.
Yeah. Now, one thing you did like on the previous version of this.
There's lots of things I liked. Which one are you going for?
The high integrity board.
Yes. So we've got obviously the SPD there on the non-RCD side, but you could actually adjust that, especially you've got a spare way and your buzz bar kit. You can actually adjust it to have a high integrity circuit, say for steel or armoured feeding a sub board, maybe in a garage, etc.
Yeah, so that, yeah, so it is possible even just to shuffle the surge along and make room for that additional breaker in there. Yeah, it's good. So that's good. Backed out screws.
I love a backed out screw, and they're not just backed out, they are huge. No problem to get a 16 mil in any of those.
Yeah, so they're also a little bit of Loctite on there, so they're not going to fall out in transportation.
And you look at the neutral bar there, Gordon, exactly the same as before. We've got 8 terminations there on the right-hand side and 6 on the left, which is considerably more than you've got for your configuration as it is now. So you've got some spare ones there as well.
Yeah, so you could change that configuration if you wanted to. And there's even that little spirit level, Gary.
Well, when we mention spirit level at eFIXX, there's another words that accompany that.
Normally Wonky Joe.
Wonky Joe. So Joe can't always get things on the wall absolutely level first time. So we've got a nice little spirit level down there to help Wonky Joe. Yeah, we like that.
So that's that. A few other bits that come in the, we sell the accessory pack.
Yep.
We've got our bus bar that we can configure to length.
So a little bracket there that I like, which is obviously replacing the grommeted area for that one, so that fits in the back.
So that fits in that square area that we've got in the back there.
Yeah, but if you were to take out either the round knockouts at the back, and it has got a lot of knockouts all around the actual enclosure, they even provide you with a grommet strip, which saves you looking around in the van for it.
Yeah, a generous length of that. A couple of blank wares to, if you obviously you've only got one unused wares that comes, but if you wanted to remove some circuit breakers you're not used to keep on the van, then you can do that. And then a good shield to go over that bus bar as well. Lots of room at the top, lots of entries where you'd expect to see them, and you're...
But where do I like my room to be?
You like a little bit of room down this side, Gary.
Yeah, so down this side here. We'll bring the camera in a minute. And I love the fact you've got loads of room here. Okay, when I dress mine, I tend to dress them down behind the din rail and back up. I know other people dress them in other ways. So let's have a little look at that. So this big gap here is fantastic. So it gives you a chance to bring your towels around into the top of the main switch. But like I just said, there is a huge gap under there in order if you wanted to dress your cables that way. Likewise, some people like to dress them at the top here as well.
Mm. There we go. And then, yeah, got your usual array of stickers, and they're sort of, they're not the ones where they're going to take up all your fingerprints on there, so you get evidence that you've been to the project, and obviously instructions with all the torque, all important torque settings in there.
And it even tells you the amount of insulation to remove off the conductors, depending on whether you're going to neutral earth or into the top of the devices themselves.
Yeah, so I think... Yeah, some great improvements based on the feedback from obviously installers out there. BJ also do a full RCBO version that we've looked at in a separate video. I'll put an eye somewhere above the head or in the description below. But I guess obviously we want other people's comments, Gary.
We certainly do want your feedback. And the reason I wanted to look at this one again is I'd done a deep dive social media posts looking at consumer units on Instagram and the amount of people fitting dual RCD boards. And I wanted to have a look at this one and see those improvements and all the things I loved the original time that we reviewed it on the channel. And they're all still in there with those improvements they made. And we like that. However, with eFIXX, we love your comments. Is there some more improvements that you'd like to see within this board? Is this a board you regularly fit? And you love the board, okay? We'd like that feedback, and so would BJ. If there's any other comments, we'll try and get back to as many as we can.
Yeah, and if you're buying on weights, this wins.
Goes to 11.